fundamental aspect of the design of Brock Commons was that we engaged the design team and the construction team at the very beginning of the design process to ensure that we had an integrated design.
The entire team had pretty much a single-minded focus, which was to figure out how we could use mass wood in a genuinely economical, viable, repeatable type of way.
The mock-up was a two-story structure. We built it in our fab shop in Abbotsford, and it was just a test of the types of connections. We actually built a concrete core, a little chunk of concrete core, and had the connections installed on the concrete. And then we tested two or three different types of wood-to-wood connections on the structure.
What we wanted to accomplish there was to make sure that the column connections would fit, would be constructible, able to be assembled within a reasonable degree of time.
One of the first times I saw a third-party organization actually did the digital modeling of the building and then shared that model amongst all the suppliers and the specifiers. So it made it very easy. That's why when you went out and when you see the panels being manufactured, you see penetrations in there for mechanical and electrical, all that's been coordinated. And so that whole coordinated activity around a central model, very effective. You're going to see more of that in the future.
The 3D modeling became the language of discussion at all of the design and planning meetings. So we did everything from kind of clash detection and fitting the building together, clearances between different elements that are part of the building, to assembly sequence planning, and we also used the model to some extent for safety planning.
To actually see it in an animation was quite valuable when it came to things like safety and crew size and durations and things like that, how to coordinate the truck deliveries.
You know exactly what materials you need on site, so you know exactly what you need to have on site. Those have huge cost savings because they're not just cost savings on material, but they're cost savings on time. Everything lays out exactly the same. There's no tweaks. Everything is where it's supposed to be.
Being able to have a very high level of precision to the tenth of a millimeter in terms of level of definition in a model doesn't always happen or need to happen in construction. In a mass timber prefabrication building where you're prefabricating multiple systems that need to come together with very tight tolerances, that level of precision is what you need. By getting an integrated kind of workflow, by crowdsourcing ideas from the team, ultimately what it led to is when they went on site to build, it's like they have already built it before. You know, you had already built it multiple times on a computer screen, now we just have to build it live.
The entire building is within millimeters from the ground floor straight through to the 18th floor. Those precisions aren't found by just trying things out. The beauty of doing it and all of that modeling was we knew exactly where everything had to fit.
Bringing the full team together at the very beginning of design, so having the design professionals, the construction manager, key trades involved at the beginning of design really helps. We were able to erect the wood structure in 9.5 weeks. We achieved that because we spent a lot of time planning through the design process.